Hello, welcome back to the Bliss Bean. The more observant among you might be asking, is that a new sweatshirt? Didn't you just declutter your closet? Yes, I went thrifting a few days after I decluttered and said I need to stop thrifting, but I love this sweatshirt, so judge me if you want, I don't care. As I'm filming this, it is day 11 of social distancing for me. As much as I love spending time by myself, I miss my friends, I miss hugging my friends, I miss eating out, I miss dance classes, I just miss the old routine. So while we are stuck at home for the time being, it is really important for our mental health that we still stay in contact with friends and relatives. Aside from texting and FaceTiming and Snapchat and house party and sending telegrams, Morse code messages, carrier pigeons. Actually, carrier pigeons are probably not the most hygienic option at this time. But aside from all the other forms of communication that are out there, writing pen pal letters is also a really fun way to get creative, pass some time, and also communicate with others because socialization is important. I used to have a lot of pen pals in high school and then I just got busy, which is like the story of everyone's life. But in this video, I wanted to spread a little positivity, create a little bit of community. So in addition to enlightening you with my pen paling knowledge and expertise, I will also be writing pen pal letters to 6 subscribers. I chose these on Instagram. I'm really sorry that I couldn't pick everyone. I actually initially was gonna do 5 letters and then I was like, oh, okay, fine, I'll do 6. So hopefully I haven't overcommitted myself and I can finish these on time. I didn't realize until I started filming this video how sad my current stationery stash is. I am not Amanda Rachel Lee, as sad as that makes me. But since it's obviously not safe to go stationery shopping right now, I am doing the minimalist thing and I'm just gonna do the best with what I've got. I do think I have a pretty good eye for aesthetics though, so I think I should be able to get by. So the first thing I did was I went to my Instagram DMs. I had asked you guys to tell me a little bit about yourself, what your hobbies are, what you're doing during social distancing, your favorite music, your favorite colors. So like a scientist, I took notes on that so that I could personalize each letter. I had some technical difficulties, so unfortunately I only have footage of me making 2.5 of these letters, sorry. But I'll show you as much as I can of these, and honestly this video might be kind of boring if I showed all 6 letters, so I hope you enjoy it either way. I wanted to decorate the first envelope with some pretty paper, so I looked at this book I have. It's called 52 Lists for Togetherness. It was hard to find pages that didn't have text on the back, but I was able to find this one with flowers on it. I cut that out and stuck it to the envelope, added some scribbles, and then I tore out a little piece of paper to write her name and the address. So the first question you're probably gonna have is, how do you find a pen pal? Obviously, during the virus outbreak, you're probably gonna be focused on communicating with your friends and family, but in case you do wanna find a new pen pal, I would recommend Instagram. That's where I feel most comfortable looking for pen pals. A lot of people will have dedicated accounts for sharing the letters that they write and receive. So click around, message a few people. Don't only look at the big accounts because they probably have a lot of pen pals already and are busy. I'm also going to recommend using the comment section of this video to find a pen pal. So if you're looking for a pen pal, write a comment, tell us your name, where you're from, your age, some of your interests, and maybe you'll find a pen pal that way. A big concern with pen paling is safety. Now, obviously, you don't really have to worry about anything if it's your real life friends. Hopefully, they won't be using your address to try and break into your house. But if you are writing pen pal letters to someone you don't know, then there's a few things to keep in mind. So first, I would definitely recommend getting a PO box. Now, as far as I understand, the address of a PO box always includes the address of the post office where it's located. So your pen pal will know that you live generally close to that post office, which I think is fine. I think the important thing is to hide your exact address. Second, I have already revealed my full name on the internet. It's too late for me basically to go back now. Most of my life is on the internet, but you might want to stick with using only your first name in these communications just to add another layer of privacy. Your pen pal doesn't need to know your last name. Honestly, they don't even need to know your first name. You could use a nickname if you wanted. In your letters, try to share only general information. You might view your pen pals as your friends, which is great and fine, but you have to remember that you don't personally know them, so you don't want to share anything that could, I don't know, be used against you, I guess. So for example, if there are issues going on with your family right now, I probably wouldn't write about that, but like if you're stressed out about homework, if you have a lot of tests coming up at school, that's fine to share. Just be mindful of it. Before you commit to a pen pal, do your research on them. So if they have an Instagram account and they have a decent amount of posts on it, they have other pen pals, that's definitely a good sign. I would also exchange a few messages with them before you start. Listen to your intuition if anything makes you feel uncomfortable. And honestly, even if you just find that you don't really share any of the same interests with them, that's a perfectly fine reason to not have someone as your pen pal too. If at any point throughout your letter writing you feel uncomfortable, like if you feel like they're trying to probe too deeply into your personal life, stop writing letters, stop the communication, you need to listen to your gut. On that note, if life gets too busy and you start feeling overwhelmed by pen palling, I would say try to make sure you even out the number of letters that you've written and that your pen pal has written to you, just because it takes a few hours to do these, so you want to be respectful of the time that they put into it. But after you've done that, don't be afraid to let your pen pal know, like, hey, I'm really busy right now, I don't have time to write these letters. You guys can still stay in touch, you can pick it back up in the future, but just remember that this should be a hobby, this should not be overwhelming, this should be fun for you.
Oh. One done. I'm gonna add all the addresses later, obviously, to protect their privacy. Pen palling is like harder than I remember it to be. I hope these letters don't turn out to all look exactly the same because I just can't think of new ideas anymore. Also, I can't listen to music while writing these, but while decorating them, I've been listening to the Dalcom Cafe Spotify playlist. Eileen from Lavender recommended it in one of her videos. It's like chill K-R&B tunes that's perfect with your latte or Americano, so it's a vibe.
First of all, here's a tip. Take photos of the letters that you write. A lot of the times I would get responses from people and I would be like, I don't remember what question I asked that prompted that answer. Or I would forget which pen pals knew which facts about me, so I was afraid that I was starting to sound like a broken record without intending to. The first letter is probably gonna be the hardest. It might feel a little awkward, but you just have to get through that. So introduce yourself, your name, your age, where you're from, talk about your interests, and don't be afraid to elaborate so that your pen pal has something to work with for their letter. But remember, don't get too personal. We already covered this. Once you get into it and you get that conversation going, it'll get a lot easier because just as you're reading your pen pal's letter, you'll be able to think lots of things that you can write in your response to them. This applies to like all communication that you'll ever do in life, but don't forget to ask the other person questions. If you're just talking about yourself, that can very quickly kill a conversation. And lastly, you might be thinking like, oh, my life is so boring, there's nothing interesting that I could write about. But the fact is, we all have very different lives, and so the mundane details of your daily routine might be really interesting to your pen pal simply because they're different from their daily routine. This is especially true if you live in a different country, so just don't underestimate how interesting your life is. Okay, this is definitely one of the most fun parts of pen palling, I think. Things to include with a pen pal letter. So first I want to talk about paper things. These are inexpensive ways to personalize a letter, and it's also nice because they lay flat so they can easily fit in an envelope. So you can write out a playlist of songs or a list of book or movie recommendations. You can include a little souvenir of your daily life like metro tickets or museum tickets, a little tag of questions for them to answer or like a this or that game, Polaroids, drawings, photo cards, recipes you like. If you live in different countries, then some sort of a souvenir is great, like a pamphlet or a map or a small sample of your currency or like that thing where you take a coin and you put a paper on it and you take a pencil and do this. In terms of gift ideas that are slightly more bulky, some washi tape samples, paper clips, sticky notes, any kind of stationery you might have. I really like to send tea bags because then you're really like sending the whole experience of drinking a cup of tea and reading a letter. I just think that's so on brand with pen palling. Maybe you can send a very thin piece of candy, some small jewelry like earrings. Just get creative with it. If you keep up this pen palling thing, you're gonna end up with lots of letters, so what do you do with all of them? I think making an Instagram account for it is really fun. Don't worry about like growing your following or making sure all of the photos are perfect. It's really just a fun way to share the letters that you've received. For storing the actual physical letters themselves, I would recommend having one box for all of them, and then maybe you can divide the letters that you've received from each pen pal into separate Ziploc bags. Other miscellaneous advice, I would definitely recommend trying to find a pen pal from another country. It might be more expensive to send the letters and it'll probably take longer for them to get there, but it's really cool to be able to learn about a different culture that way, and also just mind-blowing that the letter that you're holding in your hands traveled across continents and oceans to get to you. Finally, don't put too much pressure on yourself. It's cliche, but it's the thought that counts with the letters. They don't have to be perfect. You don't have to have the best stationery. Just write a thoughtful letter, include some thoughtful gifts, and you are a pro pen paler. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. I hope these letters arrive somewhat quickly and safely. I do have a P.O. box if you guys ever wanna, send me anything. Please don't feel like you have to, but it's there. The address is in the description box. If you're looking for a pen pal, tell us about yourself in the comments. Look at other people's inquiries. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please give it a like and subscribe to my channel. Please stay safe, stay healthy, and I will see you next week. Bye!